his place, I suppose, in rock and roll in Ireland was that he wrote the map.
I walked in the door, down the hall, and heard the music playing. And of course, I thought it was a tape or something, you know.
It was just so in tune with that instrument, you know.
Rory Gallagher was his guitar.
His energy on stage was something that you were just blown away by.
It was just like watching a real craftsman. You know, this wasn't a guitarist, this was a craftsman at work. There's no comparison. Rory was the top man.
He was an absolute genius.
He put 110% in every gig.
The essential ingredient was excitement.
One doesn't have to look far to understand just how much Rory Gallagher's music means to the people of his home city of Cork. Born in 1948 in Ballyshannon and raised in Cork, Rory was passionate about music from an early age.
Rory was stage struck by the right age of 9 when he got his first acoustic, his first 6-string guitar. He couldn't wait to get on stage and would play sort of church socials. He formed a skiffle band. He would then play school concerts and that, like, you know.
When he came in here first, I would remember him in wearing sharp pants, you know, which I think probably around 9 years of age, I'd imagine, you know. He bought a small steel string guitar. He was obviously playing quite a lot, and practicing that because he was breaking strings regularly for every guitar he got, which can happen if you, you know, play a lot. You know. So I can remember on one occasion my sister talking to him in Merchant's Quay and saying, "Rory, you're breaking an awful lot of strings. Is there something wrong with your guitar?" And he kind of said no, and she was saying to him, "Why don't you bring it in and we'll look at it to see?" Because he would have been breaking strings much more than other guitar players, obviously, because he was playing an awful lot.
As Rory's skills developed, he recognised the need to join a professional band in order to continue his musical progression. In 1963, Rory joined a show band called the Fontana.
He then had to join the show bands, which were the dance bands who would play for 6 hours a night to entertain the troops.
And the show bands were very important because they were a part of our development as a culture in terms of music. In the same way that perhaps in Britain it was the kind of the folk jazz combos and the folk clubs. The folk clubs kind of built up a lot of music in Britain, whereas here the folk clubs were certainly there, but they were smaller and it took a while, a little bit later really. It wasn't until the mid to late 70s that the folk club really evolved and people came out of that whole movement.
There was no kind of rock scene. Rock music hadn't been invented, as it were. That was the only way you could get work, you know, in a more serious sense, and also stage. And Rory, by then, had acquired an amplifier, which hadn't gone down too well at home, so he wanted to crank it up. His hidden agenda was to develop these guys into more like a rock band or a beat band, which he did. And after 2 years as the Fontana Show Band, he had moulded them into Impact. Instead of the uniforms, they had black polo necks and black trousers, which was quite out there.
In 1966, Rory left the show band to form a three-piece group called Taste.
The sound Taste were making was just remarkable. And then seeing them on stage,